you are having struggle and lot of difficulties with non-cooperation from physical and mental bodies. And if time is also non-cooperative, you have to struggle more. So this time, in earlier time 4 to 6, that is very cooperative. But at that time dawn, we are not so prepared, but we will be gradually preparing ourselves. What? That is time cooperation. Then the position in which we are seated like this. So putting all of your weight in the Merudanda, that makes you to create a grip in the medulla oblongata region by which the Sushumna is vetified. By means we are capable of learning and imbibing more. The system has been totally abolished by the European culture of sitting and writing in desks and all of these things. And then, and also in empty stomach, if totally we are hungry, we cannot practice anything. If we are fully packed and stuffed inside, we cannot learn anything. So it must be a mediocre. Before hunger comes, or in a position where we can manage hunger, or in a position where we can give preference to knowledge more than hunger, that time is very suitable and conducive. Likewise, we are in a good spiritual ergonomical background, and the place is also, you see, there is good granary and it is a hut-like structure, and it is a place where a lot of people, they have done their contemplation, meditation and mystic practices. So all of these things are additives which make us certainly to reach the goal which we are here demanding or desirous or deserving to get. Okay, we can start with the program. In the previous lecture, those who attended, they must have heard about the different types of healing. I just told a lot of healing systems, thousands of healing systems, in which we were mentioned a few 20 or 30 systems we have mentioned. Likewise, we have to start with the healing, how to heal one's own self and how to heal others. It is not an instantaneous project. So you must not take this project as, yes, today's project is learning and tomorrow it is healing. So this is unimaginable. But it is a threshold, we can start that. So there are three types of people. One type of people, those who are engaged in the process of spiritual healing. Number two, those who are engaged in the process of other systems of healing, who wants the additive benefit of spiritual healing also. The third thing is persons who are business entrepreneurs, business magnates, academicians, professionals, those who want the healing system as a way of service to the society or at least to their family or their personal selves. Could you follow that? So that's what I told, one third is general. After finishing that one third, I have to classify all of you and put you into batches. Then by these 10 or 12 lessons, we will be completing the BTEC in bioenergy. That syllabus will be formed and that will be contribution of the Supra Foundation for the world. The first time, the first thing of its kind. So generally I have to classify all of you and give general introduction. Today also these practicals are general practicals. General theory, customized theory. General practicals, then specific practicals, exclusive practicals. So these practicals are also of three types. So now we have to start with that. Depending upon the person's caliber, I have to put, what is your taste? You like bitter or you like sweet or you like sour, salt, what is your taste? What is your color? That is not your complexion. What is the color that you prefer? And what is the nature of your appetite bearing, your digestion, your physical, you are sentimental, you are emotional, you are sensational, all of these backgrounds by which we can create you a common category. For example, there are common criteria by which they are put into phylum in biology, like Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Platyhelminthes, Echinodermatis. It is a phylum study. Likewise, it is also an antophylum study in which the persons are the basis of their action, interaction, reaction, counteraction, response, reply and reverberation, they must be put in columns and they have to be given names. They belong to that group. So there are 12 major groups, like 12 zodiac signs, and there are 12 subgroups. They are known as Upadhyaya, and they totally constitute 144 major groups, which are further divided into the power of 144. So these things, main category 144, we can go and we can finalize the numbers, put them into groups and start the specific type of healing. Specific type of healing is for the person. Exclusive type of healing is for the disease or for the person who is the beneficiary. Okay. Now we can start with the process of healing in a particular subject. As discussed earlier with Sujata, we have been calling a lot of diseases are there. That which is having a larger and a tremendous impact in the society, where each and every person is dying both by the disease and also by the fear of the disease, you have to take such fatal as well as the fatalistic diseases that is there adorning the society now in multitude, both quantitatively and qualitatively. and that which has poor services, and that which has lot of mysteries that have not been properly unveiled. So that type of thing I talked about, the diabetology and other things, gynecology and pediatrics and everything, we can start with this healing system because nothing is impossible. Here you have to understand, the healing system for spiritual healing persons, that will be intensive course and training. And persons, those who are engaged in Ayurveda, Siddha, Allopathy, Yunani and other systems like I have already mentioned, crystal therapy, aromatherapy, color therapy, magnetotherapy, radioesthesia, then musical therapy, that of other therapies are there, cosmic abundance, cosmic therapy, reiki therapy, pranic healing, lot of systems are there. Those who are classified, are there any practitioners of medical systems of healing here? Raise your hands. Medical systems, only two. Non-medical systems of healing like crystallography and other alternative systems of healing, micro systems of healing, what are you? Okay. If you are having both Ayurveda and pranic healing, but taking into consideration pranic healing and having the additive of this thing is very proximate. From Ayurveda to divine healing, it has a more distance when compared to the distance between Reiki pranic healing and this divine system of healing. So forgetting yourself as an Ayurvedic practitioner, except at your home and your dispensary, you have to take into consideration that you are into pranic healing and you have to proceed. Are there any other people who are academicians and other normal professionals or retired people and social service interested or counseling people who want to learn these things? Yeah. So this is how we have to classify these people. The syllabus, the common for the three things we have to study. One is the energy source study. It is known as energy source study. It is a study about the energy resources and the energy resources management. That is common for all. That is a common subject. And second thing, anatomy and physiology of human body and functions. Spiritual anatomy as well as the peripheral anatomy. I have already told about physical, microphysical and paraphysical. I have already briefed it in the previous lecture. So likewise, these subjects are very common for all people. After completion of these things, spiritual healing persons, their diagrams and structures are very different. And other people in the other systems of healing, either proximate distant systems of healing, either materia medica healing, or non-materia paramateria medica healing. Paramateria medica healing is not with materials but with energy. Materia medica that deals with materials like herbs, toxins and other things. So for that we have to classify. I think that the next thing will be the classification of the phylum level of each and every participant here. So this time we have taken the heart. So heart is very significant because apart from the physical governance, heart has three governance. One is the physical governance. Each and every part is activated by the supply of prana. Prana, prakrishena niyate anena iti prana. As everything is led by the force that is known as prana. Prana is not oxygen. Prana is any force. Oxygen is having that type of force for us. So that is known as oxygenesis. The whole systems of the cosmos, there are two types of major creations. One is aerospirate and respirate. Most of the creatures, they respire, and there are hundreds of creatures which don't respire at all. Some respire through nostrils, some through beak holes, some through gills and some through pores like plants. And the devas, the celestials, they don't respire at all. They are having intra-respiratory system in which they rotate their own energy on the basis of rotary kinematics. So celestials, they exist by that. So the prana, the vital energy for supply of the essential force which have been extracted from the nutrients. Food is sent inside. Food is assimilated in the form of nutrients. Nutrients give a nutrient vital breath or air which is known as oxygen, which is carried by the process of oxygenesis throughout the body through blood. So that major function is done by prana. So that is physical governance. So first, before learning your heart, just please close your eyes and just think. See, understanding it as a mamsa pinda, a flesh package, is entirely different from understanding the function and envisioning divinity inside it. Just close your eyes. Whatever I say, I am going to say only in English. Sanskrit things can be learnt afterwards. Just you